Hello friends, welcome to Quick Glance Videos. Today we'll discuss about prokaryotic cells, their features, structure and functions. Prokaryotic cell is one of the simplest primitive form of cell which makes up the unicellular microorganisms called Archaea and Bacteria. Bacteria can also be called as like Eubacteria or true bacteria, and most of the prokaryotics are true bacteria. Archaea bacteria are ancient bacteria, and they differ from the true bacteria in the membrane chemistry, the cell wall structure, and they are found in extreme environment of the earth. So this is a slight difference between Eubacteria and Archaea bacteria. Now looking at the domain, so we can divide the domain as eukarya domain. Then we have Archaea domain, which has eukaryotes, prokaryotes, nanarchaeotes and prokaryotes. These are all primitive type. Then domain bacteria, we have proteobacteria, chlamydias, spirochetes, cyanobacteria, gram-positive bacteria. This forms the true bacteria. This is how the domain is divided. Now we'll see about the features of prokaryotic cell. They are the primitive cells. They have evolved on 3.5 billion years ago. The size of prokaryotic cell, which is visible only through light or electronic microscope. Most of these cells are diameter ranging from 0.1 to 10 microns. So a micron is, if I say 1 micron equal to 10 raised to power minus 6, or 0.00039 inches. So this is the relation between micron and inch. Cell structure, they are unicellular. The nucleus, they lack nucleus, true membrane, and they lack true membrane bounded by nucleus. They have nucleolite. DNA is not enclosed inside the nucleus. It's circular, single, double-stranded structure called, it's a coil structure called nucleoids. Chromosome, one pseudo-chromosome called plasmid. Cytoskeleton, not present in the cell. Ribosome, small quantity of 70S ribosome is present. S is a Wittberg unit. So, Wittberg unit. So 70S has two sub quantities. They have larger 50S and smaller 30S. So these two ribosomes are found, and 4 to 8 ribosomes combine together with messenger RNA and forms polyribosomes. So these are the structures which are found in prokaryotic cell. Cell organelles, they lack organs like lysosome, endoplasmic reticulum, mitochondria, Golgi. These all things are absent. So there is no cell organelles in the prokaryotic cell. Chloroplast, they lack chloroplast, but chlorophyll is found in some of the cells. They are scattered in cytoplasm. Flagella is single fiber. The flagella helps in mobility, so motile. Plasma membrane, they lack carbohydrates and steroids. Cell wall present in all prokaryotic cell and gives structure, integrity and shape. So cell wall gives the structure, integrity and shapes. Cell division mostly takes by binary fission. Genetic material, it is partially transferred to through process like transformation, transduction and conjugation. These are three processes by which the genetic material is transferred and from one bacteria to other bacteria. Cytoplasm is granular crystalline colloid complex that fills the whole prokaryotic cell excluding the nucleoid. So other than nucleoid, if you see the cell, so there is a nucleoid structure, coil structure, this is flagellum. So this structure is filled with cytoplasm. This area is filled with cytoplasm. Pilus or fimbriae, it's a hair-like structure which is sticking out of plasma membrane. So they are motile, non-motile. Phyllus and fimbriae are non-motile. They can be found multiple numbers. They are found in 4 to around 1 to 4 per cell. 1 to 4 per cell. And collectively they are called pili. It helps in exchange of genetic material during conjugation. So the phyllus helps in conjugation and fimbriae is more of bristle like and helps in adhesion and clinging of the bacteria. So it's more in the surface and more the function of is adhesion of the cell and clinging. So this is a slight difference between phyllus and fimbriae. So this is a complete cell structure. So if you see, you have phyllus, capsules, this is the outer three membranes, so this is a capsule, this is a cell wall and the inner plasma membrane. So three layer structure is there. Then we have nucleide. The nucleide is a DNA, it's a highly coiled structure and between them is cytoplasm. So between nucleide and inner cell membrane is the cytoplasm. Then we have flagella, ribosome. As we said, this is a 70S ribosome. So this structure will go in details. I'll briefly describe each structure. Cell envelope. It forms a protective covering and maintains the shape and prevents from bursting. So cell envelope it prevents the cell going bursting, osmotic bursting, to avoid osmotic bursting. The three layers, it has outermost layer, glycocalyx, the capsule, the outermost capsule, the middle wall and the innermost wall, the plasma membrane. So inner is the plasma membrane, the middle wall and outer wall. So you can see here the outer, the middle, the inner. The outer layer, the outermost layer of the cell envelope, which is chemical composition of polysaccharides, which is without protein. So it might contain protein and or it might not contain protein. The glycocalyx is thick, tough. It is called as capsule. The outer layer is called capsule. And it forms a loose sheet-like structure. It's called slimy layer. So some bacteria might have this slimy layer. Some bacteria might not have this slimy layer. So we see the outer cell wall. The outer cell wall in gram-positive and gram-negative bacteria. Now this gram staining was done by Danish scientist Hans Christian Gram. So Hans Christian Gram. He brought gram staining where the staining of the bacteria takes place in different color on the base of the cell wall composition. So if you see gram-negative bacteria, the cell wall is thin. And peptidoglycan layer is very small. And in case of an on staining, it gives blue color. In case of gram positive bacteria, the peptidoglycan layer is thick. And on staining, it gives pink color. So this is how we differentiate between gram positive and gram negative bacteria. So this forms the outer layer. The middle layer or the cell wall. The rigid middle layer of the cellular envelopes that provides shape and prevents bacteria from osmotic bursting. So it provides a complete shape for the bacteria. The gram-positive bacteria is uniform thick, 10 to 80 microns. So we saw in gram-positive bacteria it is thicker. And gram-negative bacteria is thin, 2 layered, 7.5 to 12 microns. So this you have to remember is thin in gram-negative bacteria and gram-positive bacteria it is thick. This we can see here, the peptidoglycan layer in gram positive bacteria is thick. This is a cell membrane, this is a thick layer, and in case of gram negative it is a thin layer. This is the outer membrane and this is a cell membrane, the plasma membrane. It also has a periplasmic space. The inner layer. The innermost layer of the cell is a cell envelope. It is semi-permeable. It allows certain material to pass through it, and certain material it blocks. Quasi-fluid and dynamic in dynamic membrane. So semi-permeable, that's very important. It retains the cytoplasm. The inner liquid is retained by this inner layer. It prevents loss of essential components through leakage. Aids in the movement of nutrients, waste, and secretion across the membrane. Hold the receptor molecule that detects and responds to chemical changes in the surrounding. So it's one of the structure which helps to hold the cytoplasm and responds to the inner and outer chemical composition. Also prevents the leaking of the components of the cell. The other structures which are found, I will describe in briefly. Cytoplasm, as we said, it is a granular crystalline colloid complex which is between the plasma membrane and nucleoid, and it contains various structures like mesosomes, chromatophores, ribosomes, inclusion bodies, and plasmids. Inclusion bodies are like food reserves. It can be organic or inorganic. Gas vacuoles, chlorosomes, carboxysomes, etc. They are non-living structure and are found in cytoplasm. Plasmids are ring-like self-replicating extrachromosomal double-stranded DNA. They are found in cytoplasm. They act as a genetic material in the cell. And plasmids are divided on the basis of functions. So plasmids can be divided on the basis of function, various functions they perform in the cell. So they help in exchanging genetic information. And on the basis of function, there are different types of plasmids are there. They are also called mini chromosomes, as they carry around 5 to 100 genes they have. And on the basis of functions, they are divided as, say, sex plasmid, R plasmid, pole plasmid, and so on. Nucleoid. Nucleoid is the genetic material of the prokaryotic cell that occupies around 1/5 of the interior of the bacterial cell. It occupies the 1/5. It's a highly coiled structure you saw in the picture, represented by a single circular naked DNA which is highly looped and super coiled with the help of polyatinines. Polyatinines is the nuclear proteins and RNA. This helps them to make a super coiled structure. So if you see the bacteria cell, super coiled structure, this is the nucleoid, and this is connected to the plasma membrane either directly or either with the help of mesosomes. This is how it is attached to the plasma membrane, the nucleoid. The last is the appendages. Though the surface of the appendage is present on the bacterial cell may be motile, is a flagellum, or non-motile, pili. As we described earlier, it can be motile or non-motile. So non-motile are pili and fimbriae. We already saw the difference between both. The motile format, we have flagella. Now the flagellum is connected, has three parts. So the flagellum has the basal body part, the filament, the hook, and the basal body structure. So in case of gram-positive bacteria, it connects to the outer ring with the help of L ring and P ring. And inner membrane, it is connected by M ring, the basal body, and the S ring. So this both rings are present in gram-positive bacteria. Now in gram-negative bacteria, only the S and M ring is present. Only S and M ring is present in gram negative bacteria. The flagella, it has ability to rotate 360 degrees. It shows a 360 degree rotation, helps in mobility of that cell, and it is around 45 nanometer. Nanometer means 10 to the power minus 9 meters. So this is a brief about the cell structure. So just to go through a revision. So these structure on the left side are sometimes present in some of the cell, and these structures are always present in all prokaryotic cells. So we have a slimy layer. So as we described earlier, it's a outer layer which is sometimes present in the bacteria, photosynthetic membrane, mesosomes, granules, pili or femorae, anything one is present, plasmids, glass vacuoles, flagellum, and these structures like cell wall, plasma membrane, respiratory enzymes, cytoplasm, ribosomes, polyribosomes, nucleoid, food reserves, RNA, these are always present in the eukaryotic, prokaryotic bacteria. Coming to questions of Krugman's questions, so three questions you can answer in the comment section. What are three layers of bacterial cell? What are differences between flagella, pili and femorae? What is the coiled DNA called in prokaryotic bacteria? Also friends, subscribe to Quick Glance video channel and also click on notification so that any future uploads coming in this section, you can get notification for that. Thank you.